The World Food Programme embarked on a food prioritization assistance program among the refugee committees. The program saw the food rations the refugees were receiving from the international organization reduced. Under this program, the refugees were categorized into three. The first category will be receiving 60% of the food assistance. The second category will receive 40%, while the third category will not receive any food assistance. Emily Doe, the head of the World Food Program in the southwestern districts of Uganda, says the categorization exercise will see those who have the means of supporting themselves weaned off from the program.
So that's where we are. Now, one thing we need to understand is that since we talk about a funny situation, you can't put everybody in the same situation. If I'm able to work, manage on my own, I need to step aside so that what was given to me before can be reallocated or redeployed to other people who are more vulnerable. And that's exactly what we are trying to do now, so that the most needy can benefit from the most assistance from us. So our assistance now is needs-based. And that doesn't mean that a refugee who doesn't get WFP rations any longer will be stripped of their refugee status. No.
The cutoff in food rations has left a number of refugees in the settlement communities stuck wondering how they can sustain their families, as the camp commander for Ramwanja Refugee Settlement Camp in Chegwega District explains.
Because of donor funding, the rations have been reduced. Others will be weaned off from the food. And it is now up to the government of Uganda and some partners to venture into livelihood to manage the issues of refugees. Otherwise, today we are in the Kabarugota to receive this building. We are moving to Kakoni, where they also constructed the same building.
This has forced the refugees to find alternatives of survival as they seek to bridge the gap brought by the food cuts from the World Food Organization. In the Ramwanja Refugee Settlement Camp, the refugees have formed a group focused on commercial vegetable growing with a view of overcoming the food shortage and taking advantage of the fertile land surrounding the settlement. With a total of 28 members, these have since formed a group called Agriculture Development Association. The members not only grow vegetables for their own consumption, but also started selling the surplus to neighboring communities.
Tupo tunakomalisha, tunauzisha, watu wanafanya saving, na kule mshida mdogo mdogo, batu vrema, bako nakumaliza juu.
Kabalolo Research and Resource Center has supported the members by securing 10 acres from landlords to enable the refugees' farm.
So what KRC has done is we have gone into a partnership with the local communities, the host communities, particularly in Ramwanja, where we have worked with our partner called Uganda and supported a section of young refugees who can be able to access. So they have been able to go into an agreement with the landlord, where they have accessed 10 acres of land to plant food, particularly maize, which can be used for production, for sale, but also for food. So with 10 acres on someone who gets a plot of 30 by 30, it means that he has had an extra food basket, but also sustainability in terms of access to finance, but also having more money at the end.
Home to more than 70,000 refugees, the 2022 statistics from United Nations High Commissioner for Refugees indicate that Ramwanja Refugee Settlement Camp hosts 81,915 refugees from the Democratic Republic of Congo, 327 from Rwanda, 123 from South Sudan, 47 from Burundi, 12 from Somalia, 7 from Kenya, while countries of Tanzania, Central African Republic and Eritrea each house 2 refugees in the same settlement camp. Story compiled by Jonathan Tusingwire for the news.